Hello, I'm in my garden today and I thought I'd have a look around my garden with you and give you some tips and ideas about how you can attract nature into your garden. So I think lots of people have been spending more time outside if they've got a garden in their gardens or in the parks, and there's nature all around us. Okay, so here's some things that you could do at home if you have a garden to attract some nature into your garden. This is a patch that I let grow quite wild so that the insects and the wildlife are more encouraged to come here. So we've got some lovely foxgloves. This one's huge, really tall. And the bees just love that. I don't know if you can hear any buzzing on the video. Perhaps not. I've made a pond and sometimes I see frogs and toads come there, although I can't see any creatures in there at the moment because this weed has grown far too big. So later on in the year, when there might not be any baby frogs or toads growing in there, I'll have to have a bit of a clear out. But at the moment, I've got to leave it alone in case there are any in there. Here I've put some bird feeders with seed in for the birds to come and eat, and behind that you can see a big bush with some purple spikes of flowers. They're just starting. Later on, maybe in a month's time, there'll be loads and loads of flowers on that bush, and all the bees and insects will come to collect the pollen. One way that you can attract nature into your garden, maybe some birds, is by putting fresh water for them, especially if the weather's been really hot and there aren't any puddles around. You could put some water in a bowl. Maybe you've got an old dish or something that you can put some water in. Try to make sure that you keep the water fresh and keep the bowl clean. That's the bit that I'm not so good at, but it's quite important so that the birds don't get diseases. Okay. If you let your grass grow a little bit longer, like mine, I normally just leave it for 3 or 4 weeks between cutting it. It might look a bit messy, but you might get some clover or some daisies or buttercups, and that will help the bees as well. There'll be lots. So down behind the trees here, I had some old roof tiles, and I've made a bit of a mini beast home, a bit of a mini beast hotel down here. So you might have a little out of the way place where you could put some twigs or some old wood. That's nice for mini beasts. Okay. If you can have some flowers in your garden, you can see this bee enjoying the flower and he's collecting his food on there, collecting the pollen. So that will really help nature too. Plenty of flowers, all different types, all through the year. Yeah, it's gone around the corner. Okay, well, I hope that helped. I hope you found out some interesting tips for attracting wildlife into your garden. And the best thing that once the wildlife is there is to take some time and sit and enjoy it. Okay, maybe you could take some photographs. I know a pupil in my class sent me a lovely photograph of a woodpecker that was in her garden, so she's obviously been having a look at the nature in her garden. Email me at the school and let me know what nature you found in your garden. Okay, I'm going to leave you now with some nice relaxing nature sounds and a bit of a video. Bye bye.